Cowboys, Panthers coming up on EA Sports. We welcome you to Charlotte, North Carolina for today's game.
Well, Phil, we've got a terrific matchup at running back. Two of the most dangerous backs in the NFL about to meet, go toe-to-toe. How do you see it?
Well, you know what? It's not always about the quarterback when you talk about NFL games. And here's a great example of it today. The game of football is still about the most physical team wins. And when you have running backs like this, the more physical team will win.
The Panthers out now in a 4-6 formation. First down at the 20. That's Romo finding Bryant. Bryant's marked down at the 34. Can you believe how steady and reliable this guy is?
What's the phrase for it? He is money, Jim Nance. Man, he pays off every single time. You throw the football near him, he'll make the catch.
First down coming up.
Get ready.
Witten's got the catch and the first. Lined up, two tight ends set. Gets the handle here. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. That's a nice, powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Now, Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here, but, you know, somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense is going to have to put some weights in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle.
Romo stepping back into the shotgun.
Dez Bryant with the catch.
They come to the line and it's first down. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. And a gain of four. Past winner of the Walter Payton Award, Jason Witten, a steady influence at tight end.
I think you said the word right. It is steady. He just keeps marching along every single year. Big numbers in receptions and putting up big yards, too, when it comes to receiving yards.
Second and six. Tony Romo uncorks the long pass. Jack Thompson at Washington was all over the field during his days with the Huskies.
Well, Ron Rivera, coach of the Carolina Panthers, is a defensive guy. So what did he do? He went out and got another extremely athletic guy to put in on that defense. They are going to be tough this year.
Has space. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
Here they come to the line at the 23. Tony Romo will take it right from the center.
When linebackers move around like this, you know what it means? Nothing confuses no one.
Chili, a first drive, and a first touchdown. As we get near the end of the opening quarter, they've grabbed the lead with that touchdown.
Yeah, things have been rough so far, haven't they? It's been fun to watch. Each team is being very competitive and physical, but that's a nice thing to do, to score that touchdown and get a lead here late in the first.
This is Whitaker running it out. And it's the same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. Newton's going to be in the pistol here. First down at the 20. Has his target. The Panthers now move the chains.
Well, if you want to be a good play-action pass team, it's always nice to have a good running game. Make the defense dig in and try to stop your run. When they do that, you fool them. You fake it, you throw it down the field. That's about as easy as it gets.
Picked up a couple that time. The running back position will be handled today by Jonathan Stewart out of Oregon.
Well, it seems like Jonathan Stewart's been in the NFL for about 15 years, and he just keeps running the football, having success. I like the way he runs. I like his style, and he is productive.
The Panthers load up the backfield for this next play. Second down and 9. Newton's running away from the pressure. One of the keys to the Cowboys' secondary is cornerback Brandon Carr.
Big 2012 free agent signing, and you and I were there when he single-handedly won the game against the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Third down now. The quarter is about to end. One more play first. Newton can't find the target, and it's incomplete. The Panthers have to punt the football. We'll see what he can do here. Picks up 8 here. The Cowboys offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. That was a solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, just look at them, Jim. The way they run onto the field, you can see they're exuding confidence. And when you got a confident football team, man, let them go and let them play and see if they can make it happen again.
First down at the 16. Allen's all over that offense and brings him down.
Look at those linebackers shifting around, trying to confuse the quarterback.
Charles Johnson gets to him for the sack.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback, and the best person to do it is the defensive end. What a good job that time by him.
The Cowboys come out, jumbo package on the field. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
The defensive line is shifting. They're getting into a spread look. I think they think this is going to be a pass.
Staying with the passing game on first down. And it's a catch by James Hanna. That's a gain of 7. That's his first reception today.
The Cowboys did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short, much easier to call those kind of plays.
The Panthers defense now is going to go nickel. Met by Davis that time.
Look out here. They're going to blitz. They're all packing the line of scrimmage.
First and 10. Intercepted.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
The Panthers bringing their offense onto the field. It wasn't a very productive possession for them last time out, partner. They ended up punting.
Well, you know what it was? It was a good feeling out process. So they got some knowledge by watching the defense and what defenses they tried on them. So you got to take advantage of that knowledge and come out here and make some plays.
Second down. Stewart's lined up in a single back formation. Midway second quarter. Got drilled as he throws it.
Well, but it's third and long. I just say this, be very careful on the offensive side.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The Cowboys come out in a dime package. And looking underneath, this will go incomplete. It's becoming evident here, partner, that this defense has done quite a job so far and is ready for this occasion. I know it's only the second quarter, but they've dictated the pace of this one.
You are right. I know it's early in the game, like you said, but so far the defense is winning the battle, and I think we kind of expected that coming into today's game.
Brought down at the 38. The Panthers defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Gets about 9 on the play. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day. This will probably be the last play before the 2-minute warning. We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I just spoke with a Cowboys official. At this point, the medical staff is going to hold him out of this one with what they're still just calling an upper body injury. So, guys, he's out for the day. Back to you.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Romo's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under. Intercepted! Made.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Panthers weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jimmy. If you do that by showing different formations and plays, you saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in. I know I get in a lot of bad businesses.
Second down and 10. Stewart's got it. Screen play.
Situations you go over so many times in practice and training camp. Know what's going on the offensive side, how to preserve time. Good job that time by the offensive player. Get out of bounds and give his team more chances to get it done here in the first half.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Stewart's the receiver on the screen. Touchdown, Carolina. And just before the half, they battled back and tied the game. That could do a whole lot for the mood of that locker room at the break, Phil.
No question, Jim. It just gives you an emotional lift to find a way to tie a football game up right before halftime. That was a nice drive and a good job done by the offense.
Fields the football at the 3. And he'll step out of bounds. And a run back of about 20. The Cowboys offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go. Go out there. Be aggressive. And see if you can score some points. Oh, look at that. Linebackers moving around.
From the gun, Romo. Comes away with it. Can you believe how vertical he got there?
I can believe it, Jim Nance. I can, because we see it so often. The receivers in the NFL are just unbelievable. We take these catches for granted, but that was a tremendous play.
Romo's completion percentage, 70% on the day. Can't find the target on the pass underneath.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
The Cowboys snap it at the 36. Bryant's going to pull in the bullet pass. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
Man, he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong we are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
Dallas in the end zone. Bill, they have the lead now here late in the second thanks to that touchdown, and they should have it, in fact, when we go to the intermission.
Oh, now you're seeing the future, huh? So you know those things. I'm just kidding, of course, Jim. Like to have a little fun with you every once in a while. But, hey, nice drive by the offense. That puts them in a great frame of mind going into halftime here soon.
And this is Whitaker running it out. Spins away from the hit, and the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. The Panthers offense preparing to get this drive underway. The last possession ended in a touchdown. Phil, let's see if they can do it again.
Very well done. Loved what I saw out there on the offense the last time. They mixed it up, and they showed a lot of confidence. You can see the speed of the football team and try to duplicate what they just did.
A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. We'll be back to Charlotte after the break for the start of the third quarter. Welcome back, folks. Jim Nance and Bill Sims here at Bank of America Stadium for the call as the second half is about to get underway. The second half is officially underway. Webb's going to run this one out. And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. The Panthers talk things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Gets the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here.
You knew this was going to happen, and the coach disagrees with the call on the field.
There's no question he caught the ball, but there is a question whether or not he got both feet in bounds.
Well, first off, you want to make sure it's a clean catch on the sidelines. Does he have possession of the football? And then once you declare he has possession of the football, let's look down at both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget, you must maintain possession of the football as you go to the ground. The Panthers look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
First down at the 49. And here's the throw. Cam Newton throws it down the field. That's reception number two for him.
Well, you got to worry about everything when you play Cam Newton. Him throwing the football, running it, and also the long throws down the field. That was a beautiful throw by Newton that time.
This play set up by the long gainer. Stewart's taking it on the screen. The Panthers get a first down.
Nice play call that time by the offensive coordinator. A little screen pass to the halfback. He knew the defensive line was going to be charging hard. They were, and it picked up some nice yards.
First and goal. Newton's completion percentage, 60% on the day. They will snap it now at the 7-yard line. Second and goal from the 7. And now Newton's going to take off. That's a gain of 6. Third and goal from the 1. Runs it across. Touchdown.
If the defense is not going to play for the quarterback sneak, then make them pay for it. Take advantage of it. That's what the offense did. The quarterback took advantage.
Let's get the injury report from Danielle Bellini.
Guys, I just spoke with a Cowboys official. They wouldn't specifically say what the injury was, other than it's an upper body injury that won't stop him from returning. Back to you.
To the end zone. The 20, the 10, all the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
You can never talk enough about special teams in the NFL. It truly is a third of the game. And when you get a kick return for a touchdown, that just gives you so much momentum. Look at the blocks. Look at the speed of the returner. Great job. Leads to a touchdown.
This is Whitaker running it out. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
The Panthers heading back onto the field on offense. They scored on their last drive, Phil, and they did it with a blistering aerial attack.
Quarterback is hot. He is getting protected. Oh, man, what do you do now? I think if you're an offensive coordinator, it doesn't matter what you call. You know your guys are going to make it work.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Newton's on the move. Did not get both feet down.
Newton's mobility, boy, gives him a chance to make a play, doesn't it, when you force him out of the pocket, but not able to complete the pass because nobody's open.
The Cowboys with 2 extra defensive backs in the dime. The Panthers will take the snap from the 25. He has the grab, and he's tackled down after picking up the first.
The Panthers, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Newton's completion percentage, 60% on the day.
Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back. They need to make a big play here.
First down at the 19. Jonathan Stewart with the catch. Stewart's brought down after picking up 11 on this play.
First down by the offense in the red zone, and, you know, if you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
Stepping up, ready to spring into action at the 8.
The Cowboys load up the box, going with the 46 defense. First and goal from the 8. Lawrence is all over the ball carrier.
Oh, my gosh, it is the worst thing you can do on the offensive side. This drives coaches crazy. When you get down near the goal line, you run the football, and you lose yards. That's just not being tough enough.
Coming up to the line at the 11.
Newton lines up in the pistol. Second and 11. He's drilled as he throws.
Big situation right here. Touchdown ties the game. We're in the second half. What will the defense do? Will they be aggressive, or will they not take a chance?
Quarters formation here for the defense. Third down and 11. Reaches out and snatches it. Picks up about 2.
Arm strength is a nice thing to have when the window of opportunity is very small. Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
A short field goal try on the way.
The kick is good.
And that field goal should help to make this an entertaining fourth quarter.
Well, I have no doubt it's going to be an entertaining fourth quarter, but I thought the coach should have not tried the field goal there that time. I would have gone for it on fourth down and tried to get 7 points.
And as he takes a knee, Romo will now bring his offense onto the field. The Panthers will come out in the dime. Two tight ends on the field here. And that's a gain of 9. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day. No time to huddle now.
Look at the signals. The D-line is all shifting down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
Second and short. They'll go ground. The tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
The Cowboys, they never back off. That first down, they got a small lead here in the second half. What are they looking to do? They're looking to march this football down the field and score.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt.
Over, over.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Catch made by Bryant. That pass play wasn't good for much. So now it's second down and 9. Romo standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. He's hit as he throws it. Third down on the way. Romo's ready for the snap, empty backfield. Romo's going to take it from the gun. And the QB is hit and dropped by Short.
You got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing, they're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
Again from the 27. Jones is there that time for the tackle.
The Panthers love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
The Panthers will come to the line. Still a very close game here in the fourth quarter. The scores 21-17. Stewart's ready to run off the screen. Ball's out.
The Panthers just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
The Panthers have it at the 34. That's a gain of only a yard. Coming to the line at the 33.
Time is running out. The defense knows it's playing with the lead, but doing whatever it can to just try to run out the clock.
Tackle's made, and the first down is picked up. Wasting no time now for this next play.
These guys need to make something happen on offense with time beginning to run out.
Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage. The Panthers have gotten their running back involved throughout this game, but it's been through the air where he's made a huge impact. Stewart's been a big part of the offense on the ground and through the air.
Yeah, there's nothing like a game plan when it comes together. And that's what's happened right here. They had a plan, and it is working, and that is a sweet feeling for the offensive coordinator. Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Easy catch there, no one near him.
The Panthers did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Newton's on the move. Ball is out. This one's going back the other way. Newton's just fumbled the ball away on what could very well have been the game-deciding drive.
It is worse to fumble the football than throwing an interception in these type of situations. You know, interceptions, coaches can accept those because you're being aggressive, trying to win the game, but fumbling the football, that's just not being smart. Oh, you see the linebackers moving around. I think they're trying to confuse the offensive line.
Handoff made. And Keekly in on the tackle. That'll stop the clock with that timeout. Second down now. Second down and 11. And he makes the catch. No, no, the ball comes out. The ball is knocked out of his hands. In a dangerous spot here. Backs to the end zone, stepping up to the line at the 6.
Third and 11
to Williams, and it's spotted away.
Your football team is losing. All the pressure's on the defensive side. They come through, they get it done. Now it's fourth down for the offense.
Again, we'll try his return. Tackled right around midfield. They needed the ball back, and they got it off the punt. And now they need points, and they do have timeouts to work with here in the final 2 minutes.
Yeah, having those timeouts is everything. What do we always say? Use those timeouts in the first half. In the second half, protect them like their goal. Give this offense and the coach credit. They saved a couple, and that's going to help them in this drive.
That's a gain of 6. The Panthers still trail, but as we look at the passing numbers, it's hard to find much fault with them. Newton's led his team on the field today and has posted some very impressive numbers.
Yeah, the offense has been sharp, and I'll say this, in the NFL, if you're trying to make a comeback, man, intercepted!
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20.
The Cowboys offense getting ready to start this drive, and things are looking good for them at this stage of the game, partner.
Yeah, this is where it gets tough, though, Jim. They got to find a way, make the right play call to get one first down. If you do that, that puts the other team in a very tough situation.
Tony Romo will take it right from the center. First down at the 20. The ball is fumbled, and it's a takeaway.
On his way,
taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
What a backbreaker for the offense. To have a turnover here in the fourth quarter when they have the lead, the defense takes it back for a touchdown. Terrific job on the defensive side.
The Panthers getting ready to kick it away. The 18-yard line. The Cowboys offense takes the field, and they are absolutely in desperate need of a big-time drive here to put points on the board.
The one thing we do know, since you are behind, the defense most likely is going to be very conservative the first couple calls. So make sure you have play call to take advantage of the fact that they're going to be very conservative.
Intercepted! Romo's has got to be hanging his head after that series. Here he was attempting the last gasp heroics, trying to take him down to win the game. Instead, he throws the interception.
Sometimes as a quarterback, you cannot be afraid to fail. And that's how he acted on the field that time. He was aggressive in his decisions. He was trying to win the game, and it just didn't work out. But when you know you can win the game, but just running the football, then you just run the football. Take no chances. Keep two hands around it at all times, and don't worry about the extra yard.
Newton lines up in the pistol. The Panthers have it at the 44.
Line to the left.
And pick up about four. After that last carry, it's third and three.
The game is close. It's in the fourth quarter. You're winning. You're on the offensive side. You find out if you can really run the football in these situations. That time, short gain on the run.
And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first. The Cowboys stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second. Takes the knee. Is every win sweet, or are the close ones that much more satisfying than just blowing someone out for 60 minutes?
Well, the close ones are more satisfying because the tension is there longer. And the longer you're under tension, when it finally comes to fruition and you win, it just makes it that much more exciting, Jim.
Sims and all the crew, Jim Nantz, saying so long.